Welcome. My name is Ibama Melford, and the topic for today is data collection part 1. By the end of this lesson, you should know what data collection is all about and how to represent data in frequency table, pictogram, bar chart, and pie chart respectively. Data collection is a process for gathering information from different sources. For example, in a class of 35 students, find out how many students like rice, beans, yam, and plantain. Now, from the information you got or findings, you discover that 15 students like rice, 6 students like beans, 8 students like yam, and 6 students like plantain. You can decide to represent the information you've gotten in a tabular form like this. Okay, so this is your data. There are two types of data: quantitative data and qualitative data. Quantitative data, this is any data that is in numerical form, just like the example above, that is quantitative data. Qualitative data, the type of data is descriptive. For example, color, appearance, quality. What that means is that if you have a bag that contains balls of different colors, you can decide to separate them in their colors. Okay, all right, let's move on. Let's look at some vocabularies that we'll be using in the course of this study. Primary data is information that is collected directly. Secondary data is information that is collected by someone else. A frequency table is a table that lists items and shows the number of times the items occur. Frequency is represented by letter F. A pictogram is a chart that uses pictograms to represent data. A bar chart is a diagram in which the numerical values or variables are represented by the height or length of lines or rectangles of equal width. A pie chart is a type of graph that displays data in a circular graph. Here, look at the self example. 60 students use different means to travel to school. 25 travel by train, 11 travel by bicycle, 15 travel by car, and 9 by canoe. Use the information to form A, frequency table, B, a pictogram, C, a bar chart, and D, a pie chart. A. Now, from the question there, you can represent that on a table, just like the table you're seeing here. Now, the frequency there represents the number of students, okay? So, that is that for A. Then B, pictogram. Now, a full picture there is equal to 5. The reason is that we don't want to litter the page with pictures. Alright, so a full picture represents 5 or is equal to 5. For example, 11 students travel by bicycle, so equal to 5. 2 bicycles will give you 10. So it's remaining 1 left. So you just have to use a fraction of the bicycle, okay, to represent the remaining, you know, student, okay. Then 15 students travel by car. 1 car there is equal to 5, 2 cars, 10, 3 cars, 15. So that gives you, you know, the number of students for that use car. Then for train, how many trains are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so that gives you 25. 5 times 5 gives you 25. Then 9 students travel by canoe. You know, the first canoe there is equal to 5, remaining 4. So you just use a fraction, then the remaining, you know, number of students. Okay, let's move on. A bar chart. Okay, so you have to plot a graph of frequency against method of movement. So let's look at it. Now, 11 students travel by bicycle. So the bar for bicycle, you trace it down to frequency axis, which is a level. Okay, the bar for car, you trace it down to frequency axis, which is 15. The bar for train, trace it down to frequency axis, which is 25. And the bar center frequency as which is 9. All right, then lastly, the pie chart. Remember, pie chart is circular graph and angles round a circle sum up to 360 degrees. Okay, so angle, we'll use angle of the sector to represent the method of movement. Now, the first thing we need to do is to sum to get the total frequency. And for us to get the total, we'll sum all the frequencies, meaning 25 plus 11 plus 15 plus 9 will give us 60. So for us to get the angle for each, you know, sector, this I will do it. Now for train, 25 student travel by train, so 25 divided by 60 times 360. Okay, we are using 360 because we're talking about the full circle, all right? So 25 divided by 60 times 360 will give us 150 degrees, or you can say 25 times 260 divided by 60 still give you the same thing. Now for bicycle, 11 divided by 60 times 260 will give us 66. Okay, for car, 15 divided by 60 times 260 will give us 90 degrees, and for canoe, 9 divided by 60 times 360 was 54 degrees. So these are the angles of the sector. So the next thing you have to do is to draw a circle. You can use your compass to draw a circle, okay, regardless of the radius. You can use any radius of your choice. Now for you to get the angles of the sector, you can also use a protractor or any other method of your choice. So now for train, the angle of the sector is 150 degrees. So you can see the angle for the train there, 150 degrees. Then for bicycle is 66 degrees. So bicycle will take 66 degrees. Sector for bicycle is 66 degrees. Then the sector for car is 90 degrees. Okay, car there 90 degrees. And the sector for canoe is 54 degrees. So that's how to do it for pie chart. In summary, data collection is a process for gathering information from different sources. A frequency table is a table that lists items and shows the number of times the items occur. Frequency is represented by letter F. A pictogram is a chart that uses pictures to represent data. A bar chart is a diagram in which the numerical values of variables are represented by the height or length of lines or rectangles of equal width. A pie chart is a type of graph that displays data in a circular graph. You can try this exercise. Thank you.